Cześć, witajcie w kolejnym odcinku filmu Omen z gościem. Jest ze mną Mitch. Hi, Mitch.
Hello, Mr. Omen. Thanks for having me.
Thank you for having you here also. Mitch, jeśli ktoś się z Was nie orientuje, ogląda WOTA, zawsze odpowiada za prowadzenie filmów i wprowadzeń między grami. So basically what I said is that you are responsible for introducing the teams, introducing some tactics between all the matches, right?
Yeah, in the past, the last few events, that was my role as the host. This event, a little bit different, I'm casting on the main stage. So two pairs of casters, Lauren and Ollie, and then myself and Randall.
Okay, so because right now we are playing final, the grand final, the big finale. Can you tell me, did you expect that final?
I don't think anyone expected this kind of final. Maybe Hellraisers, we thought they might be in it, simply because they had always been close to Na'Vi in their skill level. I mean, at the Russian finals, it was 5-4 to Na'Vi, so close. But to see EL Gaming in the final, I don't think anyone expected that. This is a team that has been around for a little while now, but on the world stage, like this, has never competed. Very impressive, definitely not expected.
I think you will agree with me that every Polish guy here was supporting Kazna Crew for obvious thing. But what do you think about Kazna matches?
They were great. I was lucky I got to cast most of them actually up there. I mean, it was intense, like exciting stuff. These guys always seem to find a new level every time they come to an event. It's maybe a little bit of a shame that they lost to EL Gaming. I thought that's a game they could have really won. But these unexpected tactics, they weren't ready for. That being said, Kazna, great games over the weekend, and they're only going to get better.
One interesting thing for me right now is, you probably agree again, that ESL or esport in tanks changed a lot because on a previous events we played with heavy tanks, with most heavy tanks and tier one. Right now we are playing most with light tanks. What do you think about that change?
I think it's a good change at the end of the day, because now there's always an attacking team, there's always a defending team, right? So the attacking team has to come forward. I mean, we think back to season 3 in Tiche, great example. It was like the grand final, two of the best teams in the world, but it was like camp, draw for 4 rounds. We played like 13 maps just to try and find a winner.
Now, okay, but now we are talking about tactics. What about tanks? Because we changed tanks like 180 degrees.
Yeah, absolutely different, because now the attacking team needs to be able to attack but be confident in attacking. In the past, they sit back with big tanks and they just blow them up. Now you need to be fast, and because there's two caps, right, you need to be able to move around the map a lot quicker. That's why these light tanks are coming in.
I've heard the opinion that one team, I think Na'Vi, is not perfect with light tanks. They are still trying to play like heavy tanks early on.
That's right. These teams that were the best back in the old format, Virtus Pro, good example as well. Na'Vi, teams that love to sit back, play defensively, play static, so not move around too much, are now finding that these younger teams who are mechanically skilled, their mechanics and their speed is overcoming the tactics and slow play of teams like Na'Vi. And that's why we saw the result we did today. That's why Hellraisers won.
Okay, and about the event, what do you think about second grand final in Warsaw, but now in Expo 21?
First of all, I think there's no better place to have a World of Tanks final than in Warsaw. Poland or Warsaw, Poland is the capital of World of Tanks esports in Europe. It is the place to be. I mean, you can see we filled this whole place up. People can't even find seats. Would we get the same crowd elsewhere? I don't know. I don't even want to find out. I think this is the perfect place for it. And the venue is big. Yes, it's a little bit out of the way of the city. It's not, you know, it's not the Zloty Tarasy. It's a little bit further away. People are still making the trip to get here, and we're just going to keep getting bigger and bigger.
So you think maybe and next grand final, there is a chance to have you in Warsaw, Poland?
I've heard talk about our next event. I think Poland is still the best place to be. Something bigger though. I've heard talks of
National Stadium.
Don't knock it down, but it might. It's a possibility. I mean, we don't want to run an event and not fill up a place. We didn't know if we'd fill this place up. Obviously, you know, the Polish crowd is always going to come out and support their teams and support the game. I think it's a possibility.
But on the National Stadium, we have I think 53k places right now. Here we have 1,500, 2,000 people, right?
Yeah, about that. Normally, like when we see esports in stadiums, It's not the whole stadium that's used. What you'll often find is they'll set up a screen at one end, a big screen, and a lot of the oval itself or the area on the ground is sort of filled up. The ESL 1 Dota finals are a good example of this, I think, in Frankfurt at the arena. It looked really good on camera. Obviously, they didn't fill the whole stadium. We're not quite there yet, but I believe it is possible. We've seen.
But we are going the right way.
Absolutely. You see other games. I mean, League of Legends is an example. They will fill stadiums. I don't think we're too far behind.
Okay, thank you for the interview. And last question, the grand final. Obviously, my viewers will know the answer, but who is going to win?
Honestly, I think Hellraisers will be a little bit too good. I think Hellraisers will get the win. I'd love to see an APAC team get the victory. The thing is, Hellraisers know how to play aggressive teams. They're used to this aggressive stuff. So they might just be a little bit too good. It could be anyone's game. I don't know what your viewers are saying, but I think Hellraisers will just have the edge.
Okay, so let's go and watch the finals. Thank you for the interview.
No worries, let's do it.